in two, in one. Holla, boys, and a bro fist to all the edgelords joining me tonight who have been singing aloud to the most ridiculous music ever to hit college days. Oh, it's so fucking old school, man. Keep it alive. The heaviest riffs this side of Twitch being dropped. How is everyone doing on this wonderful day? I hope everybody's doing tremendously well as we've been kicking off and doing all kinds of stupid shit here, including... Yeah, we officially tested VR porn. We did it. We did it. We had to. You kept asking us. The emails kept coming. And we had to sit and we had to make the conversation, which was, we're gonna have to test VR porn. Otherwise, people are just gonna keep fucking asking us about it. And yeah, we did it. Which Ghosty was quite happy about, I believe.
It was amazing, mate.
It was not amazing. It was exactly as we thought it would be. It was weird.
Amazing.
It was weird. It was weird. So we'll talk about that at the web show. We'll talk about it at the web show. Where we sample. We had to. It cost us 15 quid. We had to get multiple players to make sure we were doing it correctly. Because we weren't sure if we were doing it right. Because it was all weird. But there we go. We tested it. So now we know. No stream. No, surprisingly, no stream. No stream at all. So we did it. Yeah, we did it. It's a thing. So we'll let you know about that on the web show. It's a great weekend because at 7 o'clock in the morning, me and the Gooch are off to that Birmingham where we're going to be streaming to our afternoon for Twitch. Hey, because we're not a religious show anymore, apparently. We're not a religious show. So 11 till 1 is our slot for Twitch to do stream stuff. I believe it's going to be on our channel, I think.
Well, yeah, it will be, because it was on her channel today, wasn't it?
Yeah, it should be. So, we'll be streaming tomorrow at the Twitch booth. We're not doing the Intel booth. What?
Oh, sorry, carry on.
Okay. Yeah, we're not doing the Intel booth. Now, so we'll be doing... I'm hoping to do some Mythic Pluses, maybe about level 8 or 9. We did level 8 earlier, so we might be doing 8, 9, maybe 10. We're getting to that point now where our group setup's kind of a problem. Are you guys there in your Mythic Pluses? I'll tell you my group setup for Mythic Plus so far. It's up to 8. It's a Boomkin. It's a Shadow Priest. No, a Boomkin. A Priest, which is Dis Unholy. A Warlock. Me. And a Prot Pally. Not ideal. Not ideal. So hopefully we'll be able to rock and roll with some late Mythic Pluses. Or we're deciding whether we're going to do like heavy Mythic Pluses. Or we might do the Emerald Nightmare normal with you guys. Something like that. Something like that. We might be doing something like that. So we should hopefully have something lined up. I'm not going to do my dailies or anything. So yeah, fucking Warlocks. Yeah, Warlocks indeed. You did 10 today. I think we might need to bring in the Trash Man for 10. We need the Demon Hunter Trash Man. We need the Demon Hunter Trash Man for getting that, I think. I don't think the old Boomkin and... I mean, I'm all right. I'm a Fire Mage and broken, so that's okay. But still, even with Skittish, which is the best for your Fire Mage. It's all right. It's all good. Wasn't that bad. It was okay. So we'll be doing that. Now, some of you may have noticed as well, because Blizzard has actually announced it now, is me and Ghosty are hosting the Warcraft DVD launch. Yeah. Why Blizzard recommended us for the Warcraft movie DVD launch? I don't know. Of all the things they could recommend us for, it's the Warcraft movie DVD. So I assume they thought it was really funny. But still, we're going to be hosting the launch of the Warcraft DVD. They're having a big party. They're calling it October. All the stuff and all that's kind of going on now. So we're going to be down in Dat London. Well, it's actually cool. It's actually really cool. We're going to get a load of copies of the movie on special edition, which comes with a load of really cool shit to give away. Hype. So that should be good. We can also give away... You ready? You ready, nerds? We're giving away burgers for October. We're going to be doing a lot of promotional stuff. So we're going to be in London on the 12th of October. I'm apparently not allowed to tell you where the event is in the evening because they're giving away tickets. You have to give a like on the Warcraft Facebook page. So if you go to Warcraft's Facebook, you'll see a post about October. They're just calling it like the special launch event. But I'm allowed to tell you, me and Dickhead are hosting it.
Why are you always insulting me every time?
Me and the Cleft are hosting it. We're going to be hosting the big event, which is in the nighttime, where there will be big beers. But it's in London, I can tell you that. But for sure, they've already announced we're going to be at Tommy's Bar during the day for the Orc Burger. I don't know what it is. It's an orc-themed burger. So we're going to be... we should have a load of tickets to give away free food as well. So we're going to be doing all that kind of stuff. We're getting loads of giveaway stuff. There's also some archery involved. But I'm not sure if we're going to be able to do that. Because it's on a different day. So they're debating... They might have to pay us to come back for a different day. And we're just like... It's a lot of work, man. Do you really want to like pay us to come and play archery a second day? So I don't know what the Orc Burger is. But if you're in London, come say hi. Is what I'll say. Come say hi. And if you want to meet us and have some big beers in the nighttime, I can tell you the place it's at doesn't hold very many people. It's like a couple of hundred. But we're hosting the show. And we have a lot of leeway in what we can do there. Yeah. So if you want to come and have some big beers with me and the douche, then you can come on down and just, you have to give them a like. Maybe we'll get some tickets to give away. I don't know. They're not really telling us yet. They just told us what we need to do. So that's what's going on there. And obviously then we'll be at BlizzCon. And if you're a Patreon, which fucked up the internal messaging system and everybody got access to the email that we use for the top tier Patreons, I'm going to have to change the email because you zerged it. Most of you were like, hey, just letting you know you did this, but a lot of you were like, oh, thank you. We can come in there and do this now. I was like, no, this would take me hours to reply to. This would be a nightmare. So I do have to change the email. I'm really sorry. It was supposed to only go out to like the top tiers, but it went to everybody. So what are you going to do? What are you going to do? But yeah, in all good things. Okay, then. That's not why you're here right now. So hopefully I'll see you guys in London. Ooh, if any of you are at EGX tomorrow, please come and say hi. We're going to be there all day. Hopefully getting access to a lot of games early, which is going to be really nice. Okay, then. Let's have some fucking drama, then. I've got through all of my shit. So we're going to start with a little newbie story. I do want to say this, though. This is serious. This is serious. We don't often get serious on the show, right? It's a fucking goofy chill out at the end of the week on a Friday. We chill down. We fucking relax. But some people use drama time as a way to vent, like, really personal issues. Sometimes it's a little bit weird. Sometimes it's okay. We got one from a guy who suffers from schizophrenia, right? And he's had a really horrible experience in life. And then he ended up playing WoW, which has kind of allowed him to have some separation from people and stuff. And things were getting better until people in WoW became people in WoW. And I just want to say, we read your story. We're sending you an email reply. But big love coming from everybody here for that situation, my man. Big love. Big, big love. So I hope everything works out for you, dude. If you don't read your email, but you see this... Big kisses from my chat. If my chat can give me a big edgelord stream of thumbs up, loves, kisses, and PG edge, that would be fantastic. Thank you, Mr. Ghost, for leading that charge. What a hero. Yeah, it was a lovely story. I mean, it was not lovely. It was depressing, but it's okay that you're getting there, man. We hope you get there. We hope you get there. We don't wish any ill on anybody. Right then, let's have a little newbie story. I do love my newbie stories. Hello, Preacher. Thanks for the great content. Here is my newbie story. I was first introduced... Oh, I should change the name. What the fuck am I doing? Amateur hour, man. I swear to God, every week I get worse. Oh, it's actually called My Drama Story. I'm just going to call it Newbie Luck. Okay, there's no name in this one. Hello, Preacher. Thanks for the great content. Here is my newbie story. I was introduced to that World of Warcraft at age 8. My mother having downloaded the game from some private server... Your mum plays a private server. I mean, what hope have you got at that point? What hope have you got when your mother plays a private server? Not only that, Preacher, but this server had been dead for about 10 years. How old are you? How old are you? You're very, very small. I remember my journey like it was yesterday. Was it yesterday? Was it yesterday? The ball-crushing hardcore of Vanilla WoW on the private server still haunts me. My first character was a human warlock, which I thought looked awesome. You could set people on fire. You could scare them. Oh! It's not called fear anymore, lads. It's called scare. Like Monsters Inc, man. I can scare you. Ah, scary motherfucker. That's edgy. I like it. That's edgy. You could scare them and you could devour their souls. Oh. I felt like I was the shit. I was the absolute spooker Z, really. Progressing into Red Ridge Mountains. All that progress, though, at level 30. I was approached by another warlock. "Why haven't you got a pet, retard?" he said. It's very World of Warcraft, isn't it? "Hey, why you not got a pet, retard? Never met you before, but that's my opening statement to you, mate. Why is your pet, retard?"
Wow.
All right, I'm going to have to do a kiddie voice, aren't I? My what? That is when I saw his Voidwalker. His Voidwalker looked amazing. Instantly, I asked, Where did you get that? "Stormwind, dickhead." And then he rode away. I recalled a suppressed memory of me throwing away my imp quest item because the quest to Stormwind seemed too far away. Piece of shit out of here. Not doing that, mate. Look at that, all the way over there. That's like two maps away, mate. Not a fucking chance I'm doing that. Delete that shit. I ran back to where I got that quest, but it was nowhere to be found. I think now maybe it was because my level was too high to see low-level quests, but I do know that I deleted my character and went to sleep, sobbing into my pillow. No imp, no party, boys. No imp. Oh, do you remember when you had to get an imp? Wow, back in the day, man. No imp, no party. Gonna cry, gonna delete the character. That's it. It's over. It's all over, man. It's all over. So on the next day, don't feel bad. On the next day, I began a new adventure. I made, of course you did. Of course you did. You made a night elf hunter. Fuck yeah, buddy. I knew they had pets, so this time I would not make the same mistake. But if you remember, hunter pets in vanilla were absolute garbage. They would die from a couple of blows, that's true, and run away if you didn't feed them. Ah, oh, I love that mechanic of feeding pets as a hunter.
You know, I like that.
You and it, used to you know what? It just used to say your pet is happy.
Yeah.
It made me happy to know that my pet was happy. It made me happy to know that my pet was happy. I was so angry at my pet running away that I just rolled solo. I just rolled solo. My leveling was long and hard. I was playing for more than 8 hours a day every day, setting my alarm to wake up at 6 o'clock in the morning so I could play all the way up until 9. I can honestly say I have been everywhere and did things no other people would imagine. Like the one time I looked at my world map and saw those awesome looking sea monsters. I thought they would drop. I thought they would drop cool loot, or maybe you could make them your pet. So I packed all my shit and went a-hunting. I had no mount and had to travel on foot. I can't say it was worth it to wait for 6 hours for the sea monsters to spawn. But someone pointed out in chat that it was a great journey. Going all the way from Stormwind to Darnassus and then swimming to the nearest sea monster. Somewhere along the way, around level 20, I decided to do some math. And figured out that bows and all ranged weapons were garbage. Hang on a minute. The first Simcrafter. Here he is. The first Simcrafter. And there he was like, as a hunter, he Simcrafted. And of course, math doesn't lie. Math does not lie. At any stage, it's fucking science. And his science educated him that for hunters, ranged weapons are garbage. They did so little damage compared to Raptor Strike that I decided to no longer waste my money on arrows and just wield an axe. Look at how stupid I have been. I've been throwing money away, buying arrows, and now I've used math, which is just, that's what science is based on, right? To calculate that it doesn't even make sense. So, with that being said, melee is actually better, right? You just, maths don't lie. The logs don't lie, man. The logs don't fucking lie. I can see it right there. You absorbed all the fucking pools on scenarios. I can see it right here. It's in the logs, mate. You're fucked. Slaying countless mobs with my great axe. I grinded my way to level 30. Oh, we do have a name. Oh, shit. Where I met a guy. Oh, we're going with Macintosh. Macintosh. Where I met a guy called Macintosh. He was friendly around my age, so we formed a friendship right away. Sweet. Of course, I played much more than him. Noob. Macintosh, you fucking scrub me. So I didn't get to play with him all that much, but I still enjoyed doing elite quests with him from time to time. Oh. The leveling process was really getting to me though, guys. It was really starting to grind me down. In over a month of non-stop playing, I had only reached level 35 with his big axe and no pet. At that point, I decided to go for radical measures. Are you ready for the radical measures? Are you ready? It's pretty insane. It's pretty insane. I don't want to like scare you to death. I would ask every single level 60 online to run me through dungeons. I continue this to a point where I guess around 90% of the server's capped characters had me on their ignore list. It's the determination that you've got to admire. Kids won't stop. They'll never stop. No matter what you do, they're never going to stop. They're going to keep going, man. Over and over again, they're going to keep going. It was all worth it, though, he says. It was all worth it. It was all worth it. At that point, I didn't know anything about the end game and thought that the game would just end when I hit level cap, a final cutscene, so to speak. I grinded mobs 2 to 3 levels below me for around 4 months when I finally got to level 58. At this point, I knew my journey is soon to be over, and it gave me more strength to push forward. Me and my friend Macintosh were dreaming of how it would feel to be a fully capped level 60 character. How we would pwn the noobs, low-level horde in the Barrens. You're about to achieve the dream. It's the dream we all have, to get cap and go to the Barrens. That's the dream. That's where we want to be. And then I got a whisper from my friend. I got my presents. I got my presents, he said. I got a mount from AQ, level 60 and full tier 3. Did you ask if we could get both those things? I asked, quickly working out what he would say to me. No. No, I didn't. Enraged with betrayal that he wouldn't share what he had been given, I raged at him. You motherfucking cunt. After that, I logged out and once again deleted my character. And forget about World of Warcraft. I don't know what happened to Macintosh, and I might never find out. I honestly do hope he reads this and remembers those good times. Oh, he should have said, I do hope he reads this and he gets shit on. After those events, I had many experiences in WoW. I eventually started playing live, pimped some loot whores, got some good stuff in WoD. Oh, I got a good rank in WoD's PvP. Did you go PvP? Oh, God. Oh, my God. Oh, God, I'm sorry. I'm going to make you guys so fucking sick. I got a decent rank in WoD's PvP season as triple blood DK. Oh, God. It's a triple blood DK arena team. Get fucked. Get fucked. It's a triple blood DK arena team. With a death grip and damage rotation macro that contained the entire DK rotation pretty much, so my teammates wouldn't fuck it up. Our trio killed plenty of people. Thank you for reading my story. I really hope it makes it to Drama Friday. Be afraid, ladies and gentlemen, of the Triple Blood DK teams that are haunting your fucking nightmares. Triple Blood DK versus the Barons. Oh, it's the best. Right then. I love it. I fucking love it, man. Triple Blood DK? That sounds so swag. That sounds so good. Triple Blood DK sounds like the most fun. Oh, you know what's even better these days, though? Triple Prop Paladin, mate. They're the fucking real skills. Right, so we need a guild name, ladies and gents. If you guys would like to pick one, as I bring in Zombie. 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 You gotta love it. You love it. You'd be terrified. Oh, too much skill. Too much skill. Mm-hmm. Too much skill involved in the triple prop pally. Right then. What are we going for? The Dick Waders. The Lunar Clunge. Lunar Clunge. I'm down with Lunar Clunge. Moon Clunge. Best Clunge. Lunar Clunge. Okay. Hey, Preacher, and now full-time ghosty. Holler at you, brother.
Hello to you, mate.
I wrote you a little while ago about my adventures in Star Wars The Old Republic, which is apparently still very good. You played recently, did you not, mate?
Used to, mate.
And how much of a terrible idea it is to let your guildies think you are a different gender. Well, in the time since, I've managed to do one thing of your many chat members must crave. I pulled a ghost. The ghosting of the guild. To explain fully of the ghosting, I must pull back months ago when I left the inevitable cesspool guild, me and Zombie. Oh shit, oh no, you guys are going to be triggered, aren't you? Sorry, don't get me. Please don't be a YouTube hero. Oh no. My cesspool guild, me and Zombie, used to level and venture into the world of, eventually, mythic raiding. To lead us into this charge, we found a guild by the name of Lunar Clunge. On our tiny backwater server, they were a decent 5 out of 13 mythic guild, mate. And had taken a break from raiding till Legion. What's boss 6? Is it Garfiend? Let's take a little break till Legion. They had taken a break from Legion, and when we joined, we were offered raid spots for Legion. Zombie was to be a tank, and I would be a healer. Once we discovered the existence of an alt raid, me and Zombie quickly signed up, deciding having gear for Legion might at least alleviate the leveling process a bit. And so it stayed for about 2 months. Alts raiding on weekends with alcohol in hand until we gained member rank for Legion's release. Now it should be noted, this was a guild of essentially frat bros and those having a midlife crisis, so rules around the guild bank were just be a dick, which immediately set off a red flag and gave me ideas for a rainy day. The guild bank is accessible. The beginning of the end of this little story, ladies and gents, starts just before the launch of Legion. A few weeks prior, we'd begun raiding again to get everyone ready and prepared. A roster of people interested in raiding was put up to minimum item level requirements. What is the minimum item? Has any of your guilds set a minimum item level? Are they that stupid? Has anybody got a minimum item level for raiding in Legion? Got to have 851 item level, mate, even if you're wearing fucking clown suit of all sorts of stats and all that kind of shit. Anybody? Anybody got that? Did anybody say you can't come? You've not made your minimum item level or anything? Did anybody get that? That's so fucking stupid. It's unbelievable. 84, 830, 84, 855. Wow. You do? Wow, that's crazy. What sense does that make? That's so bizarre. So bizarre. You're trying to explain the better stats and they're like, nope, minimum needed. Okay. You must have the minimum item level and everything must be in order to get into the raiding the moment those doors opened to the Emerald Nightmare. You need at least 860 item level to not fall asleep during Ursoc. That's the only thing I can imagine. Maybe, because you have to move to the left or the right. Either way, it's tricky. Yeah? It's tricky. You can go left. You can go right. But you've got to make that decision. You can't go one way and then back again. Otherwise, you're going to wipe. It's a tricky boss, man. You've got to write down angry assignments for days. Make sure everyone knows what's going on, yeah? Don't want to get confused. Oh, did you know that if a dragon looks at you and starts breathing, you should move? First boss dead. So good. So good. During our Legion pre-raids, let's go back in time a little bit. During our Legion pre-raids, we noticed the group wiping on Archimonde in Heroic. People idly chatting mid-raid, even during wipes. The guild bank losing an oddly large amount of elixirs and potions each week. And now, 37 people interested in raiding on our new roster. People are taking all the stuff. People are getting more involved. Interesting. In a guild with long cemented friends, package deals of raiders, i.e. I won't play and I'm the best tank on the server unless you bring all 8 of my rep paladin friends, that kind of deal, which I did in vanilla to get all my friends in the guild. And the raider himself, as transparent as mud itself, there was only going to be one outcome, no matter how well we played. We were destined, ladies and gentlemen, for the bench, because all the bros were coming back, and all the bros stick together. In the interest of not losing our way into Legion raiding, me and Zombie sought out a new guild using That WoW Progress. With Zombie's friends and previous history on the server to narrow our replacement guilds down, we found ourselves a new one. Submitted an app and waited. Whoa, elitist. What an elitist making a guild app. Smart. We were accepted the day the Emerald Nightmare came out. Luna Clunge was planning on entering on Thursday. It was perfect. Perfect. Who does the first raid on a Thursday? Raid night came. D-Day. We sat in front of the Nightmare ahead of us and waited. The time came. Buttholes everywhere clenched and nothing. 10 minutes. 20 minutes. No invite. As it turns out, our raid leader had no pubes on the pitch and had in fact invited all the bros and started the raid earlier. What a fucking pussy, man. When me and Zombie kicked up a fuss, he promised the raid leader that he'll have a chit chat with us later on Discord. As he was replying to me, I was already using my Dalaran Hearthstone and heading towards the bank. Meanwhile, we headed onto voice comms, completed our little interview with our new guild, and got the invites ready. It took alts, Preacher. Lots and lots of alts. But that bank was fucking empty. And now for a smooth getaway, with a giant LOL spell out in vendor trash left behind for good measure. IG quit. And a jump later, we went from a 5 out of 13 mythic guild who was apparently struggling in the Emerald Nightmare to an 11 out of 13 mythic guild with a whole bunch of good swag to go along with it. It's 24 hours since I completed this little scam. The guild was disbanded overnight. You killed the guild, motherfucker. You killed the entire guild of bros. You killed the bro guild. What a dickhead. My mail is full of blacksmith's hammers. But I did just buy myself a shiny new mount. Raid leaders, you've got to be tougher, man. You've got to be tougher, you raid leaders. Who are like, I'll talk to him later. As if we haven't already got the message. 7 out of 10, Ninja. Brava. You guys are like, okay with that. Well, Ghost, did you approve?
What's up, mate?
Didn't get a raid invite, mate. So they nicked everything out of the guild bank and left. Ghosty approves.
Let me tell you why, though, mate.
Let me tell you why, okay.
If you got access to a guild bank, but you're not given a position in raid, yeah? That's the guild's fault, mate. That's not his fault. He's getting his due, mate.
He's getting his due. His fair due. For what? For what?
For the guild turning the nose up at him.
Oh, really?
Not in my house, mate.
Not in my house. Right, then. Oh, God, there's a lot of people in this. Okay. Many females must handle it. Do 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 hearts will do. Some of you boys joined Patreon after the Legacy. Well played. My blog went out yesterday. Nothing spectacular, as you can imagine, but still. Ghosties is next.
What?
You bloggalicious. I need one more. Employed.
Oh,
con. You got me right in the feels. Okay. Okay. Here we go. The most female name. Mm-hmm. I think so. All right. There's a lot of Scots in this one. There's a lot of Stots. Scots. Here we go. Hello, Preacher. Your lovely viewers and Ghosty if he's there.
Hello.
Hello.
I've been following your channel for about 8 months now. I've been mainly watching drama, web shows and legacy vids. Watching all of those drama times, I've always thought that most of them were fake until one actually happened to me. That is usually the way it goes. I didn't raid much in WoW, but when I started to raid, I found myself in a huge, enormous shitstorm. I did many mistakes in this story. Oh, the regrets are real, ladies and gents. I acted childish. I got jelly. Fell in love. And I used people. I am not proud of many things I have done. There may be some mistakes grammar-wise, as it's not my native language. Without further ado, here we go. You know when it's full of that much regret, it's so fucking screwed up. I have started playing WoW at the end of Mists of Pandaria. A friend of mine suggested that I should start the game as it's incredibly fun and there's loads to do, varying from PvP to killing giant bosses with other people. I wasn't really fond of the idea of PvP in an MMO, but raiding sounded really cool. So I created a warlock. You're a lady as well, aren't you? I believe you're a lady. It's a lady warlock, boys. I don't know. And started on my journey. I got to level 90 with my friend's help, where I asked how to start raiding. And he told me to do what? How do you start raiding? Well, best advice you can get. Always supported here at Preach Gaming. If you want to get a smooth ride, I mean silky fucking smooth ride, straight into raiding, you need to get yourself into LFR. Oh! Ooh, all the training you'll ever need. LFR. We're going. We're there. I had no idea there were raiding guilds other than cesspool guilds at the time. Really? I done LFR raids repeatedly. And eventually I got bored of what WoW offered as endgame PvE. No one believes me. No one believes me that this happens to people all the time! All the time! Yeah, I did all the raiding in WoW. Easy. Killed our command on the fifth go. Or whatever the determination stacks are. Yeah, easy, man. So, what else is there? What's after our command? Nothing. Our command's the last boss. Oh, right. Done it then. Easy game. Fucking shit. Time to get to Tanan. Hey! WoD came out. I re-rolled to a feral druid. Oh shit. I continued to play like this, doing LFR, garrisons, and random BGs. For the whole expansion until Hellfire Citadel. Oh my god. That sounds horrible. Oh, never mind. Each to their own. This time I decided to join an actual raiding guild. I found one that I thought would suit me. It was a casual raiding guild who didn't use voice comms. Rolled for every item. Why do you guys do this to me? Why does that suit you? Why did you read raiding guild, no voice comms, roll for everything, and think, fuck yeah, buddy. Fuck yeah. That sounds right up my street. Why? Why did you do that? Why did you go, oh yeah, that sounds pretty good. That sounds pretty awesome. I can't wait. Yeah, sign me up, baby. Invite. But it's alright, ladies and gents. It's alright. And you know why? You know why, though, it's alright? Guild Master's got a mythic raider friend. Fuck right off. Yeah, fingers out, stick it in your butthole and call that Christmas. That's what we just did right there. Mythic raider friend. Mwah. Magnifique. Magnifique. And that friend would help us a bunch. After quite some time, we did all right. We got heroic HFC. Oh, the Pog champion is real. Once we had cleared heroic Archimonde, we decided we'll have a little wait until the expansion comes out. That's it. We're going to stop there. We're not doing anything tougher than that. We don't want to get any better than this. Let's just call that aces. And we're going to wait till the next expansion. All right. Good stuff, everybody. Good practice. Good hustle. Took us the entirety of HFC, but we got there. With so few people staying in the guild after this announcement was made, we're going to stop raiding. Oh, shit. I decided to move to another guild, but my server was dead. Server was dead. And as so many of you asked me, should I move server? Yes. Yes. Go to a better server. Your life is better. So I transferred to a more populated server. Found a mythic raiding guild. And I seriously fucking wish I had never made this decision. It's going to be fun. It's going to be good. It's fine. It's fine. We're in a mythic raiding guild. What could go wrong? What could go wrong? This lovely looking guild had a female guild leader. Bastard. I'm joking. Called Hearts. Hearts. Hearts is our girl. She's in charge. After joining as a trial, I was on my first raid. This guild had already cleared until Gore at the time, Gore Fiend. But apparently after some drama, they had started having attendance issues. You guys are such fucking trolls. They had attendance issues and had to wait a while before going back to do Mythic. Oh, it's the old switcheroo. They did kill a Mythic boss once a while ago. So they can technically claim they're a Mythic guild. Problem is, right now, we can't actually do anything on Mythic, including Hellfire Assault. So, but we've definitely got people who have done that before, and we'll definitely get back to that at some point. All right? It's going to be fine. It's going to be fine. As I joined the team speak of the raid group to begin, I heard the female raid leader's voice. Oh my god, it's a female GM and it's a female raid leader. Okay, here we go. She was called Greymane. She was a Dis Priest. Boys. She was a Dis Priest who had the highest item level in the guild. Now, I don't want to just say that I just splooged everywhere. But this is a female Dis Priest with an extremely high item level. Good God. It's the greatest thing I've ever heard. I like that you checked people's item levels. What is your... Look at that item level. Woo! She had a very soothing voice. Oh shit, Raymane. She would explain every unnecessary thing in detail. But it was nice to listen to. Like a lullaby. What did she say? I have no idea. But it's so great to listen to. It's so wonderful to listen to. She's boring. Oh, yeah. Terribly boring. But it sounds fantastic. I love hearing all about Gore Fiend mechanics over and over again. It was a good first night from my part as we didn't wipe as much as I thought. And we got to progress up to Killrock. Ooh. Hey, baby, nice item levels. Really? Look at the item levels on that chick, Andy.
What's up, mate?
See the item level on that chick? Boom. Crisp. That's like a trade chat dream. A girl with a high item level? Fuck off, dude. What are you
that's
doing?
Life, mate.
What are you doing? Elasticate my pants. That's all I'm going to say. The guild had a night where everyone... Oh, the guild has a dedicated night, ladies and gents. Where everyone gets drunk and they do easy content and transmog runs. And have a bit of a bants. I can't see anything wrong with this. I can't see it. This sounds like a great idea. Every guild should do this. Every Friday should be drunken Bants night. Everything will go smoothly. I decided to join one, even though I was a trial. Greymane was there as well as one of the other officers. Draggy Ice, the paladin tank, instant bastard. Instant paladin tanks, instant bastard. I didn't like Draggy Ice. Told you. There was no apparent reason other than him having the thick English accent.
Whoa!
Did someone just fire some shots across my bow?
Whoa! What kind of twat stale did this toy story?
I know. Who wrote this? Hey, there's no need to be bullying. That's all I'm saying.
You want to bring that smack talk over here, Governor?
Governor. Now bring me my cup of tea before I slap someone with my cricket bat. Other than him having a thick English accent, and he would deny loot from other people, as he was the loot master. We technically had a loot council, but it appeared that the rest of the council were cooks. It's a loot council led by this one guy. Do you understand? It's a loot council led by this one guy. Okay. I was very silent on raid nights, but I decided to get chatty with these people on the drunken night, as I was pretty hammered as well. It was fun talking to people there as we were getting drunk and having fun. A whisper popped up on my screen. Oh shit, it's Greymane. Telling how she didn't hear me talk before and how she was quite surprised by me talking. And then we started talking. She's 25, while I was 20. We mainly talked about WoW and irrelevant stuff, but I enjoy... Oh, you are a guy, aren't you? I thought... Oh, the other story was from a lady. But I enjoyed the talking nonetheless. At the end of the night, ladies and gentlemen, that lady priest, with that item level, 850, added me on battle tag. Oh, shit. We talked nearly every day. As we kept talking, more subjects of our conversations changed as well. They got personal. I never thought of her as a lover back then. Good, you're just talking on WoW. I just want you to know, I don't consider you my lover.
What?
They're talking backwards and forwards on WoW, but the line reads, I never thought of her as a lover back then.
This guy's a fucking... He's smooth.
There's a shaven testicle or two.
Exactly,
in this man's pants.
He's going to brush your hair when he...
I love her. There's something so sensual about being described
as
a lover.
That's it.
Lover. I never thought of her as a lover back then. And neither did she. Oh, right. It's just a random line where none of them consider it. Because they're not. It's just we're not married either. Because I knew it wasn't a smart idea to fall in love with a girl who lived 600 kilometers away. Oh, it's a distance thing. It's a distance thing. So they can't fall. It can't be lovers. It's too far away to be lovers. After some while, we started talking. Oh, shit. We started talking on that Facebook. We would talk at morning now as well. Oh, morning and evening. We would say good night to each other and good morning to each other every day.
They're not exactly fucking in the pink, though, are they?
They've not taken it to the stink, but they are on the good book. It's Zuckerberg approved.
Oh, nice.
He says it again! After some while, we started talking on Facebook as well. We would talk at mornings now as well, saying good night and good morning to each other every day. But I still never saw her as a lover. Still not a lover. Things started to get really personal after some point. I started to take a liking to this girl, but you're not a lover, as she had a very respectable job, and she was just perfect in every way. Oh. I thought about doing my master's in her country and dreaming a future with her, as stupid as that sounds. Oh, you're already married. And in your brain, you've got the kids, you've got the white picket fence. It is the best relationship that has ever existed in the history of this planet. The power of a man full of testicles and imagination. loaded up, ready to fire. I can literally predict the next 20 to 30 years of our life. Let me explain it to you. It's all good. Now, I wanna check with you guys what you think is about to happen. Oh, you think abort there, Meth? You think abort there? Andy, you listening?
I'm listening, mate.
In order to move things forward, I started asking her relationship questions. Can I get a ticket to the friend zone? Anybody got one? Free pass. Can I get a ticket to... How much is that ticket to the friend zone exactly? Can I start asking you some relationship questions? I was trying to see if she liked me. She said that I was very handsome, tall, and I had a very kind voice. A kind voice. How do you take that?
Gentle lover, mate. A puff!
A gentle lover.
No one wants
I will go
lover.
Down on you for 6 to 8 hours and I will barely even touch you.
She'd be happy with that. She'd
it's like
sitting.
A feather.
Yeah.
And it stays at one speed for hours. Slow and steady. And I tell you, I expect nothing more than missionary.
You might think he's doing the right thing being a gentle lover, but bitches don't want that.
Look. I fuck on flowers.
That's what I mean.
I fuck on flowers.
They want you to grab the back of their head, jam it into the crevice of the couch, and butt fuck them.
It's like what Bill Burr says. Sometimes you just gotta know when you want to be smushed into the pillows, you know?
Exactly.
No, we want it tender as the night. That's what we're after. It's tender. It's tender. You won't even know I was here. It'll take all day, but you won't know I was there. Okay, all right. We're reading too much into this. He might have a game plan. All right. Okay. Whew. He's got a kind voice. That's all we read from that. We got all that from he's got a kind voice. We got all that from his kind voice. I found her pretty as well. Ooh, that's cold in my book. Yeah, you're kind of pretty, you know. This kept going until she said how she would love to... Oh, no, Andy! Oh, it's painful! I can't even say it! She said she would love to have a brother like me. It's so bad! It's gone so wrong! Tickets, please! Tickets, please! Relationship, what are you doing? What are you doing? Relationship questions. What are you doing? Do you think other girls would find me handsome? What do you think? Handsome? Fuck's sake, bro. Okay. Let's keep it together for now. I lost my fucking shit. I tried so hard to control myself and I managed to do it. I told her that I had never been brother zoned before. He's trying to pull it back. Whoa, ain't no brother zone over here.
How do you pull it back, mate? Tell me how you pull it back.
I'd just talk about jizz for hours.
No, mate. Words are not necessary.
I don't think I've been friend zone before.
You
I don't know.
You pull out your pipe and you smash it on the table. And look at her right in the face, right in the eyes. Don't say a word. You let her break the silence.
Just whip out your dick immediately. Just
make sure there's a noise, an audible noise when you go pow on the table.
She said, you're not in the brother zone. You're not even in the friend zone. This is like the most awkward conversation I can imagine ever happening between two people. You're not in the brother zone. You're not even in the friend zone. And I turned to her and I asked, so what zone am I in? And she replied, the very close zone.
Oh.
Winky emoji. Saved? Saved?
Murky waters, mate.
But he's potential. It was bullshit. I knew I had no chance of ever being with her. It's totally the friend zone. God damn it. God fucking damn it. Yeah, he should have just gone, danger zone. Oh, you're not in the friend zone. There. We kept talking as usual, but whenever I decided to say something weird to her, she would just give me hopes of being together. She would say things like, oh my god, this is harder than the brother thing. Oh, this is sick. I don't think we've ever had this line on Drama Time ever, but it is so much worse than the friend zone. I would love to travel with you somewhere at some point. Oh my god. It's like the dad zone, dude. That's the dad zone, like you're the protector. She feels safe with you and not like you're a predator in the room, you know? I feel so safe with you. I feel I can sleep so soundly with you on the bunk bed below me, you know? That's how I feel. I feel like I get a great night's sleep in some fucking hostel somewhere when Juan comes up to pork my beef. And you'd like sit outside the room to make sure it was all good, you know? That's the situation you're in. She was keeping me. I just threw up. You've got to let her know you're a predator. She was keeping me as her friend with little pieces of hope. Yeah, she's dangling. She's dangling. Do you think she's dangling puss?
Yes.
It's a very easy way to keep us around, isn't it?
It is.
Girls know that.
But she's not DTF, yeah?
She's saying to you, we're not in the friend zone, but I'd love to travel with you and sleep in a different bed.
Do you know what that is, mate? That's puss on a stick.
Yeah, it is. It's honey dicking.
That's honey dicking.
It's honey. She's honey dicking the man. She's honey dicking the man. You gotta be careful, boys. We're susceptible, you know? Moving away from this for a second, though, related to the other story later. Hearts added someone to the guild, which turned out to be a 13 out of 13. Elitist hardcore mythic raiding guild leader who was Scott. You can't. Is it Scott? No. And it was loud as fuck. His name was Massatron. Massatron from Scotland. So we're coming back to WoW. Massatron would come to raids with his Arms Warrior alt and he'd bring some of his raiders in his guild to help us progress. As we started to have attendance and people fucking up problems. He helped us a great deal. And he would even join drunk nights to have fun with people. I hate... Oh, you're getting alpha'd like a motherfucker. That's what's going on. In comes 13 out of 13. Scotch Prime beef, mate. Yeah? Scotch Prime... Fucking... His item level is...
Angus, mate.
Through the roof.
Angus.
Through... Massatron's item level is through the fucking roof. Good fucking Christ. Got an accent, all the beef, achieves cutting edge, yeah? Cutting edge achievement. I hated this fucker. I could read him like a book, unlike other people. He was trying to recruit our better raiders to this guild. Suspects conspiracy. He didn't do it plainly, but I'm sure he was asking officers and competent people in the guild. I had no real proof, but when I asked Greymane if he'd asked her, she would not give me a clear no. And then she would just ramble and finally would tell me she doesn't want to talk about it. At this time, Greymane was not happy. Our current guild leader was very busy with IRL stuff and she gave Greymane as the new guild leader until Legion. Other officers wouldn't do shit in the guild. And whenever someone had a problem, they would just go straight to Greymane. And as she was super nice and female... Oh, as she was super nice and female. She was sick of it. And apparently she was involved in a lot of drama before all of this. She wanted to get away from it all and get some space. She wanted to join a new guild and just raid. You know, I just need to get away and get some space. She only told this to me. At that time, she was spending time with Draggy Ice. And she wouldn't tell me how bored she was to hang out with him. And she would tell me how bored she was to hang out with him, as he constantly asked her to do stuff. She started denying him to do stuff with me, and Draggy Ice didn't like the rejection. There's another thing to note here, ladies and gents. On our guild website, you could see who was on the guild TeamSpeak at any time, if you remember. Draggy Ice would get salty from time to time at one night, he left with his main in the guild. When I asked Greymane why he had left, she told me not to worry, and he just needed a break until Legion. He would come to raid times. He would come to raids time to time, whenever he felt he could. You know, what about that? Leave the guild and just come to raids whenever you feel like it.
Merc, mate. I like it.
Yeah. Merc. He's officially a merc. Draggy Ice the merc.
hired gun.
Right, let's get back to it then. One day, we're chatting on TeamSpeak and doing some stuff on WoW. She started to talk about Draggy Ice. Was giving him crap about Draggy Ice. Giving him crap about why he wasn't doing stuff with her. And suddenly, I couldn't see Draggy Ice on my friends list. And then Greymane told me that he had blocked her on Facebook. She went mental. She was talking about how she did everything she could and how she could not believe that he would ever block her on Facebook. How rude. A Facebook blocking? That's a stabbing. Yeah? I was laughing my ass off with pride. And then I started to talk bullshit like how sorry I was and stuff. But it was all a lie. I still had hopes of making her fall in love with me. Dude, what? Really? 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 And then Draggy Ice left with all his alts. At some point, we stopped raiding.
Oh.
And Mossatron left the guild, but still kept coming to drunk times to time with Hearts. Well, and when Hearts took back the role of being GM, I was still trying to get Greymane to love me, and I was starting to get frustrated and more blunt. Will you fuck me? Will you just fuck me? I told her that I love her and I wanted to be with her. Oh no, he told her he loved her. I love you!
Oh God.
I told her that I loved her and I wanted to be with her.
Did he hold a big fucking 80s boombox up to a window as well, the fucking clap?
Rose in his teeth, thorns still in the fucking thing. She came back cold as ice. Longest relationships don't work. I don't want to say it.
Say it.
I'm so sorry for the girls and the lads listening to this. That either of us ever do or feel like this happens to us. She said long distance relationships don't work, yo. I told her I would narrow that distance. And we could still go on those holidays that she talked about. You offered to move? You offered to move. You want to move physically? You want to geographically move to the friend zone? You want to geographically move to the friend zone? The friend zone. But there's hope! There's hope, guys! There's hope! She didn't say no, but she didn't say yes either. So you're saying there's a chance! You're saying there's a chance, right? You're saying there's a chance. She still kept dragging me with her hook. Come on. And I was fool enough to continue on. At this point, she decided for good to leave. I told her that we could move on to another guild together. But she said, I don't want to drag anyone else with her and hurt the guild even more. No, no, no. You stay there. Eh? No, no, no. I'll go. You stay over there.
It's textbook passive cookism.
It's passive cookism. No, no, no. You said I shouted at her that am I just anyone to you? Oh, no. This is what he says. He gets furious. He says, am I just anyone to you? We talk every day. Don't you have any respect for me? She said she was sorry and that we would still talk as we do now. I cooled down a bit and said, okay. Okay. All I said is, please don't join Mossatron's guild. And she said, okay. Sure, I won't. There's another officer I didn't mention that will have relevance. Basco, who is a great boomkin, 18-year-old teenager who's the nicest guy in the world. Sounds familiar. After a while, Greymane left the guild. I got really upset and told her how angry and upset I was that she wouldn't bring me along. Oh, God, but mate, you might as well put a collar on. She was saying how sorry she was and all that. And then I told her which guild is she gonna join. Not too hard to guess. And she joined Mossatron's guild as a trial. I went crazy. I had so many insults to say. She even continued to say how nice those guys are and I need to calm down. Relax, they're nice guys. I kept my cool I just told her that she can hang out with those nice people then. I removed her from Battle.net friends. And I blocked her on the good book. He made the decision. I left the guild as well out of frustration. At the time, Hearts had her boyfriend as an officer who just came back to the game. I needed to find a better reason than just grey main drama to leave the guild so I wouldn't look like a puss.
Too late.
I told Basco that I don't want to be in a couples guild. Oh, nice play. I ain't been in no couples guild, bro. Ain't no way. I'm out of here. He proceeded to tell me I was never a problem and stuff, but he didn't say much. The next day, Hearts whispered me and told me how her boyfriend being an officer never caused a problem, and she was kind of mad at me about me leaving for this reason. I told her the Greymane story. She said it was okay for me to leave. Hey, it's not a problem that it's a couples guild. Let me tell you the real reason. Okay, you can go. You can leave. You can fine. I found another guild that was like the one I was in before. Eventually, I unblocked Greymane. She didn't even care, bro! She never even contacted you any other way! You unblocked her out of your own volition, didn't you? You just were like, I wonder if she's gonna contact me. Please have a message waiting. You're just like, please, please contact me. I unblocked Greymane's Facebook and sent her a message. I said she could still leave that guild of the unemployed, mouth-breathing, elitist shitstains and join my new guild that I had found that was really good. I found us a new guild.
Will you fuck me now?
She said, this is a decision I need to make on my own. If I had talked with you before joining them, you would change my mind and I would crash my thoughts into the ground. If you have even a little bit of respect for me, will you accept my joining? It's a WoW guild! What are you doing? It's a WoW guild! Will you respect my decision? Will you respect me as a human being for my choices in raid guilds? Please. And I didn't... This is the story again. I didn't respect them. I insulted her in many ways and told her to go fuck herself. And then I re-blocked her on Facebook. Double blocked. Take that. It's after this point, it's only after this point that I regret everything I did. I was angry at this point. I wanted to do damage in some way. Greymane still had alts in Heart's Guild. She was talking about how she still wanted to come to Drunk Nights and stay in touch with old friends. I still had an alt on Heart's Guild as well. I whispered Hearts, told her that I would join the guild back, but I do not want to see Greymane logging back on her or hear her voice on TeamSpeak or affiliate with the guild in any way. She says as officers, they think... They said as officers, they would think about that. And as Draggy Ice and I were not the only ones who had been affected by her leaving, it might be a good thing. She said she was going to have a talk. Then I made the mistake of talking more. I started telling lies about her. How she had always wanted to join Massatron's guild. I didn't give a shit about our guild. Which she always stated. How she had always wanted to join them guilds since she started joining our raids. How I told her Massatron tried to steal raiders from us. I lied about how bullshit of a person Greymane was. She didn't give a single flying fuck about our guild. She was always going to fuck us over. Hearts didn't respond much, but I think she agreed with me. And then we said our goodbyes. I tried to talk with Basco. Am I late?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay. We have to finish up. I tried to talk with Basco, but apparently he was super angry with me for leaving the guild and didn't give much a crap about Greymane in any single way. He removed me from friends and put me on ignore for being a big drama queen. The next day, I logged on with my single alt in Hearts Guild and saw that I had been kicked. I whispered Hearts asking, why? Why have you kicked me? She said Greymane left with all the alts as I wanted. And told me how they don't want someone who is so crazy and drama and manipulative like her and like me were not welcome in the guild anymore. At that moment, it hit me. I'd done goofed. I made both of us leave the guild and I had no longer the guild or Greymane to talk to. As miserable as I was, I sent a long apology letter to Greymane. He sent her an apology letter. What? Bro! Are you fucking kidding me right now? Are you actually fucking nuts? Are you completely knocking futs? She was angry with me, but she did listen to what I had. Please forgive me. Please forgive me for all I have done. I apologized again and again using little sensitive things we had talked about. And she slowly started to accept my apology. The only person who didn't block me in that guild, who left for a while because he didn't give a shit anymore, was Massatron. The end. The conclusion. I will raid with my new guild in Legion, and I plan to stay away from that kind of drama ever again. Please do. Please, please do. Please, please do. Oh my god. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry to finish so abruptly, but I am 10 minutes over time. I love you. I am streaming live from Birmingham at EGX 2016 tomorrow at 11 PM UK time till 1 PM. We'll hopefully be doing some high-end Mythic Pluses or some Emerald Nightmare with you guys if you're on. Come say hi. It's our first thing we're doing on behalf of Twitch. I appreciate it even if you just drop in and say hi. Don't shake your boobs on camera. Love that top though. That's awesome. Yes. See you later, guys. Bye-bye.